Hello everyone, this is LouisSim and these are some must-have mods for builders in The Sims 4. So if you build a lot, you probably use cheats such as bb.showHiddenObjects or bb.moveObjectsOn or that ridiculous one, like who came up with this, come on. So the first mod is Cheat Shortcuts by plasticbox. And what this allows you to do is to use shortcuts instead of always having to write those long and annoying cheats. They have a list of all the shortcuts you can use, and I use this a lot because I can just now press M and move the object is on, or I can press M again and it's off. Now you'll notice there isn't a shortcut for bb.showLiveEditObjects because this is a fairly new cheat, but I can show you how to also configure that one in the code of the mod. If you are not interested in this part, go to this timestamp to skip to the next mod. After you've downloaded and unzipped the mod, you should find this file called shortcuts.py. You can go ahead and open it with Notepad and you will see all this code in here. I know it looks scary, but it's pretty easy to understand. For example, here, if you write M, M-O, or M-O-O, it will run the command bb.moveObjects. So what we can do is we can modify this unlock shortcut that already runs the show hidden objects and the gameplay unlocks. We can copy those last two lines and just change the command to the one we need, which is bb.showLiveEditObjects. Now if you press U or unlock, all those three cheats are gonna run at the same time. Make sure you save the file and you're good to go. The next mod is BuildMode FreeCam by TwistedMexi. The free camera, which you can normally get into by pressing tab, for some reason doesn't work when you're in the build and buy mode. This is so annoying because sometimes you just wanna pop in to see how the room looks or take some screenshots. Well, this mod allows the free cam into build mode and it's such a good tool to have, I cannot stress this enough. I usually enter build mode from the manage worlds menu where you can't just switch back to live mode, and this mod has saved me from so many loading screens. The red shelf is a very useful tool to have on furnishing builds, especially if you want a cluttered look. There are multiple ways to use it and there are people out there who can explain this much better than me, so this is just the way I do it. I'm a beginner myself with this, so I don't know everything either. Say I want to place some clutter on this dresser, but it will only let me place this plan. I'll keep the plan there because it's important to cover that slot so other objects won't stick to it, and then place the red shelf at the same height as the dresser. I'll get all the clutter I want to use on the shelf, and after that, simply drag it where I want it to go. Some smaller objects still snap to it because I didn't cover these slots, but if you take the mouse away while dragging, you should be able to freely place them too. At the end, simply delete the initial plant and the red shelf. You might be thinking, how is this any different than just using move objects? Well, with the move objects cheat, sometimes the height isn't just right, so objects either clip through or float. With the red shelf, you can place everything at the perfect height and it's also much faster. If you have seasons, building can be a nightmare if the weather isn't right. For example, in this snowstorm, I'd have a really hard time changing the landscaping or the way the house looks. This mod by TwistedMexi eliminates any ground cover or weather effects, so you can have full visibility, but when you come back into live mode, the gameplay is unaffected. The last mod is also by TwistedMexi and they are a god when it comes to mods. This mod is incredibly powerful and I was so shocked to find all the things that you can do with this. And in this video, I will only show you some of them, the ones that I find most useful or fun. I always thought that rotating things differently could be such a cool thing to have in The Sims 4, and with this mod you can. So I wanna take this baby Yoda and place it on the wall of this house here. Make sure you have testing cheats turned on and then in live mode hold shift and click on the object. Go to tool, toggle active object, and then do the same thing and choose rotate. Make sure the right axis is selected. You can see a circle that marks the axis around the object, and then write down the angle you want. Go back to build mode to position it where you want it to go, and then untoggle the object. I think you can use this in so many creative ways and have so much fun with it, and I think it's just an amazing feature to have in the game. Something else you can do with this mod is that you can move objects outside of the active lot. For this, you have to toggle the object as active, click where you want it to go while pressing shift, and then click tool options, move active object here. The object is still completely usable, and this feature can open up the world to so many possibilities since you're no longer constrained by the lot's boundaries. So these were the mods that I wanted to show you, and please go support their amazing creators. I've put all the links in the description below. Let me know if you found this useful. I know this video was meant for people that are more advanced in building and already know how to install mods, so please let me know if you have any questions. Thank you so much for watching, and if you are new to my channel, I post new videos every week, so please don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one.